Actually, there's one case that really surprised me. I was working on a pediatric malnutrition program in northern Nigeria, and there was one child who was admitted to the inpatient unit because he was in severe respiratory distress initially, required oxygen and a subsequent blood transfusion. And even after being on the inpatient feeding protocol, receiving the milk by the therapeutic regimen for about a week or so, he was not really making any good strides. And in fact, every morning I would go in, and I was always very anxious because I was worried, you know, did he make it overnight? He was a patient that really, you know, concerned me. And it was actually with the help of the national doctor that I was working with, who did a more extensive history and, you know, really brought to the table the possible diagnosis of tuberculosis. And once we, you know, started investigating for that and decided to treat him for TB, it was amazing. He progressed, you know, very, very quickly, you know, started to gain weight, some of the lymphadenopathy started to resolve, and about 4 or 5 months later, he came back to the clinic, and you couldn't recognize this child. When he was in the inpatient unit, he was, you know, he couldn't even lift up his head. He was always prone. He was, you know, really disinterested in everyone, and he always had his eyes sort of rolled back in his head and just looked like a very, very sick child, even to someone who's not medical. Just looked like he was on the brink of death. And 4 months later, he actually was walking, and he in fact ran away from me when he saw me. So I never thought that that child would improve that much, but I think it just goes to show that, you know, with very few interventions, we basically just put him on the feeding protocol. Our national doctor was really astute in making that diagnosis without any labs, just purely based on a clinical suspicion. And with the TB medications, he made amazing progress.